بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. Dear respected viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another brand new episode of the program entitled Towards the Origin. It is a live interactive program that is broadcasted on Channel S, watched on Sky 814. Also for all those who will be joining us through our social media platform, whether it be through Facebook page now or later, or our YouTube channel, or you can also watch us, those who will be watching as well from the internet via live streaming. Inshallah, our tonight's topic for discussion is middle of Sha'ban or 15th of Sha'ban. We know that we are in the month of blessed month of Sha'ban, and Ramadan is not too far away. Now, there are certain virtues, certain preparation that we all need to adhere to, that we all need to make sure that we do it, inshallah, with the intention that we all hope to get the whole month of Ramadan. Now, what is our understanding of the month of Sha'ban? Is there anything that we have to do specifically? Is there anything that we should abstain in that particular month? And what did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam particularly do in this month of Sha'ban? All of this and many more we'll be inshallah discussing and touching upon on this topic tonight. But before I move on to the main discussion, may we take the opportunity to introduce you to our tonight's guest. He is a renowned scholar, imam and khatib of the famously known mosque, Regent's Park Mosque, and he's also a graduate from Al-Azhar University, Fadilatul Sheikh Qadi Lutfur Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much again, once again, for joining us so late at night in the studio.
It's my pleasure. Barakallahu feekum.
Now, as I've introduced our tonight's topic for discussion, Now I would like to ask you, my first question would be, is there any specific virtue, or what is the virtue of the month of Sha'ban?
Great. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wal aqibatu lil muttaqeen, alhamdulillahi hamdan yuafi ni'amah. ويكافئ مزيده سبحانك اللهم لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك يا ربنا لك الحمد ولك الشكر كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك يا رب العالمين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. After praising Allah and sending salam and salutations to our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. He is one and he has no partners. And I also testify that the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger and slave of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Now, we are passing through some blessed and important moments, important days, and some blessed and sacred months. Recently, we were in the month of Rajab, and we spoke about the month of Rajab, and we said the month of Rajab is a sacred month according to the Holy Quran. And now, today, we are in the month of Sha'ban. We are on the 9th of month of Sha'ban. In fact, now we are on the 10th of Sha'ban. And Sha'ban is also an important month. It's a virtuous, meritorious month according to the Holy Prophet Muhammad salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi. Now, before I proceed, I would like to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us another year and for giving us the opportunity and ability to worship Him and to obey Him as much as we could. So we thank Allah for giving us tawfiq to present some maybe minor good deeds to Him. And we also repent to Allah the Almighty for repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for any deficiencies or for any shortcomings or for not being able to do enough for Him. We are on the 10th of the month of Sha'ban, and we are actually coming to the end of the year, or the end of the good deeds, year of good deeds. End of the year of righteous deeds, amal as-salih. We all understand that every sector or every organization or every department has its end of the year. For example, we see financial year, end of the financial year. We see end of the educational year. We see end of the businesses. People have a day when they sit and they evaluate and they assess the business, so they have an ending of the year. So is the righteous deeds. So we have an end of the year as well. regarding or with regards to the righteous deeds or amal as-salih.
Quick question there. What do you actually mean when you say end of righteous deed or end of deed in the month of Sha'ban?
Yes, so
because we know Islamic calendar still continues.
Yes, because this is the month of Sha'ban, and then we're approaching to an important month, which is Ramadan. Mm. Now, I will mention a hadith which will clarify this question. Imam Ahmad and Imam al-Nasa'i rahimahumallah, they recorded in their book a hadith with a sanad Hassan, a sound chain, on the authority of Usama ibn Zaydan radiallahu anhu. Usama ibn Zaydan radiallahu anhu, he said, قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, he questioned the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam by saying, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, لِمَ أَرَاكَ تَصُومُ من الشهور ما تصوم أو لم أراك تصوم شهرا من الشهور ما تصوم من شعبان. So he said, Usama ibn Zayd, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or he told Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that we never see that you fast as much as you fast in the month of Sha'ban, meaning you do not fast as much as you fast in the month of Sha'ban. قال, then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the reason for fasting during the month of Sha'ban. He said, ذَلِكَ شَهْرٌ يَغْفَلُ النَّاسِ. He said, this is a month when majority of the people are heedless. They're in ghafla. So
when you say in ghafla, what is the actual term there?
So people are not conscious, and people are almost occupied with things other than the worship of Allah. And we can find the reality, we can see the reality of this hadith in our community. For example, you see, month of Sha'ban, it's a month when people prepare for the month of Ramadan. But people generally prepare materialistic preparation more than the spiritual preparation.
That's where I was coming to, because where do we notice in Ramadan, I mean in Sha'ban particularly, that we as a community, not specifically to the Bangladeshi community, the major wider Muslim community, we do some sort of, say for instance, if you start with a shopping planning.
Yeah, yeah.
Now instead of doing Ramadan,
so we see Ramadan, shopping centers.
All of those. Exactly, but then again, we don't end there, because the problems, what happens in Ramadan then, after the half of the Ramadan has passed away, then the second stage of shopping starts. It's for the Eid.
Yes. In fact, some people, they even start shopping for Eid before Ramadan.
Correct.
And I found people saying, oh, we must shop right now because things are cheap. And so we can see people are more inclined to the materialistic gains and also more inclined to the entertainment. So rather than preparation, spiritual planning and preparation, people are busy in supermarkets, in groceries, in other shopping centers. We find people are busy preparing the Ramadan. And so we see people are quite in ghafla, they're heedless in this month.
Now, what I understand or what I gather from what you have said, does that mean that we are now making it very much commercialized, like we see living in the Western part of the world, the religious festival, according to their religious scholars, they're saying that the followers of the Christianity have made the religious festival to be
the rituals made commercialized.
So are we heading towards that direction?
I think we have a tendency towards that, and maybe intentionally or maybe without intention or unintentionally, we are kind of inclining towards this kind of notions. But we must realize that these are the months, the sacred months, and they're solely or merely designed to for a servant to be close to Allah, to attain the nearness of Allah the Almighty.
Very true. And just to share my thought on that, I was recently passing by one of the high street, and I did notice a couple of the major retailer stores, especially supermarkets, without mentioning any name, have already advertised or said, welcome Ramadan.
Yes.
Now, even the mainstream...
So what Ramadan? Is it the shopping Ramadan or the fasting Ramadan?
So even I've noticed these signboards being displayed outside.
Yes, that is really true. So Prophet Asim was right. 1438 years ago, he said, ذَلِكَ شَهْرٌ يَغْفَلُ النَّاسِ. This is a month when most of the people are in ghafla. They are heedless. And then he said, this month is بَيْنَ رَجَبْ وَرَمَضَانِ. This month is located in between Rajab and Ramadan. وَهُوَ شَهْرٌ تُرْفَعُ فِيهِ الْأَعْمَالِ. So now he said that this is a month when the good deeds are presented to Allah. تُرْفَعُ فِيهِ الْأَعْمَالِ. So you can see when I mentioned the end of the year of good deeds. So it's a month when our deeds are being presented to Allah.
So when you say good deeds are only presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what about the other side?
Everything, all deeds.
Okay, so all deeds.
Yes, ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى رب العالمين. So our deeds are presented to Allah. So ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى رب العالمين. Our deeds are being presented and submitted. The files, everything is being submitted to
it's
Allah.
It's like end of year, so sort of things we do here.
Exactly, yes. إلى رب العالمين. Then Prophet said, فأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا صائم. Then he said that I love my deeds to be presented to Allah the Almighty while I'm in the state of fasting.
Why is that?
So he said, like, I would like to be in the state of fasting because this is fasting is one of the most, it's one of the best types of ibadah. It's most sincere type of ibadah, because when someone fasts, you can't tell whether he's fasting or not, whether he's engaged in ibadah or not.
And does it mean that it's one of the only act of ibadah that no one else knows apart from the Creator? Is
exactly.
that why it
sincerity,
is?
The sincerity, the level of sincerity in fasting, you cannot find anywhere else. Like, I can't tell whether you're fasting or not unless you tell me that I'm fasting today. So we see how many people are fasting, but we don't know whether they're fasting or not. So it's a secret between him and his Lord. And maybe people close to him. So Prophet was happy, and he preferred to be in the state of fasting while his deeds are presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we understand the fact that we are at a time when our deeds are being presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we find another hadith in the book of Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim rahimahumullah fi sahihain, on the authority of al-Mu'minin Aisha radiallahu anha, the mother of the believers. She said that ma ra'aytu rasulallahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam istakmala siyama shahr qattu illa ramadan, that I have not seen Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam completed a month and fasting continuously every day of the month except Ramadan. So he never fasted, according to Sayyida Aisha, any other month, like 30 days or 31 days full continuously except the month of Ramadan. And we find a beautiful story also happened in front of the house of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Three men came and they started to question and ask about the worship of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When they found out, كَأَنَّهُمْ تَقَالُّهَا, when they found out, they felt it's kind of less for them. So they said, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is a prophet, his sins forgiven, غُفِرَ لَهُمَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ, his present and past and future sins are forgiven. So we have to do more than him. So one man said, I will fast and I'll never break my fast.
But yet again, we have to also understand that even though he was forgiven, but yet he made istighfar daily, every single day.
Yes. No, those men, when they came, they kind of thought that it's less for them. But okay. It was okay for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So one man, he said, أَصُومُ وَلَا أُفْتَرُ, I will fast every day of the year and I will never break my fast. Second man said, I will never sleep. أَقُومُ وَلَا أَنَامُ, I'll never sleep during the night. I'll stay up the whole night. And the third man said, وَأَنَا لَا أَعْتَزِلُ النِّسَاءُ, I'll stay away from women. I will never get married because they keep us busy and I would like to devote myself in worshipping Allah. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he came out and he heard the conversation. He said, were you guys saying these things? They said, yeah. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, well, listen to me. As for me, I'm the most beloved servant of Allah and most God-fearing. But I fast and I break my fast because my body has right over me. Some days I fast, some days I don't fast. And then he said, I sleep during some portions of night and I stay up during other portion of night. And then he said, وَأَنَا أَتَزَوَجَ, and I do get married. And then he said, النِكَاحُ مِن سُنَّتِي فَمَنْ رَغِبَ عَن سُنَّتِي فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي, which means that nikah is from my tradition. Who he doesn't follow my tradition, he is not one of me. Now, Prophet ﷺ, he never fasted any other month completely except the month of Ramadan. Then she said, وَمَا رَأَيْتُهُ فِي شَهْرٍ أَكْثَرَ مِنْهُ صِيَامًا فِي شَعْبَانٍ, he said, I have never seen him fasting mostly or most of the days of a month except the month of Sha'ban. So Sha'ban was a month he would fast mostly and Ramadan completely. So you can see the preparation for the month of the great month, the month of Quran, month of Siyam, month of Qiyam, month of Ramadan, everything is just coming and it's a great preparation, spiritual preparation for the month of Ramadan.
Jazakallah khair for that discussion. It's time for a short break. Okay. And inshallah, before I move into the break, I just wanted to ask you a slight thing there. When you did mention that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said he also fasted, he got married, and at the same time, it means or it demonstrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a bashar, was a human.
Oh no, of course.
And at the same time, it also does not tell us that he led a life balanced.
Balanced. That's it.
Now
that's
this
it.
Is moderate. One thing because moderation. If we see now we have a tendency that if someone becomes religious, that means they will leave their family behind. they will leave other activities behind and they will say, I'm working in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, they will abandon certain things or they will say, dunya is not my place. Now, from this hadith, are we not understanding that Rasulullah balanced both the dini aspect of his life and the dunyawi aspect of his life?
I mean, there shouldn't be any kind of bias and for a specific period of time, someone can take a gap or can take a break, even for studies and other things. But it shouldn't be the case of the whole life. This I'm saying. But for a specific period of time, someone can take a break, or someone can go out, or someone can do certain things for a specific period. Obviously, with the agreement or with the consultation of the family and other people of the family members.
JazakAllah khair. Well, on that note, my dear viewers, it's time for a short break. We have been discussing about the virtues and the aspect of Shaaban. Specifically, inshallah, in our next segment, we'll be touching upon the middle of Shaaban, or 5th of Shaaban, 15th of Shaaban. And we'll be touching on certain discussion that a lot of times we hear. And inshallah, our guest in this program will be enlightening us by hadith and the Quranic verses. Do stay tuned with us. You're watching Towards the Origin, and we'll be right back after a short break. Wassalamu alaikum.